I've always done my best to be a model American. I'm a commissioned officer in the United States Army.
For your information, the communists have infiltrated our country at the highest levels. We found them in the State Department, we found them in the Justice Department.
At Woolworths, you'll find them in the Notions Department.
Now, Major. I wonder if you recall the name of another model American. One Walter Philip Crichton.
You mean Wally Crichton?
Our investigation showed that you and he were quite... close.
We dated. But that was ages ago. He was in college and I was a student nurse.
Wasn't it more than that? Were you not constant companions for 2 years? Did you not accompany him to dances, parties, motels?
I resent that implication. We never went to a motel. Wally had a Nash.
Look, Sonny, what's the big deal about an old fling?
For your information, Walter Philip Crichton has been named as a subversive by the House Committee.
Wally Crichton? What could he have done that's subversive?
Walter Philip Crichton was a founding member of an organization called Freedom for Tomorrow?
Freedom? Disgusting. Next thing you know, they'll be threatening us with liberty and justice for all.
This woman had a long-term intimate relationship with a known communist, had the same friends, shared the same interests.
There you have it. Ironclad innuendo.
Where there is smoke, there is fire.
Yeah, just ask Joan of Arc.
Williamson, your whole case is a busload of bourgeois. You're talking about the finest nurse I've ever scrubbed with. And you haven't said diddly squat about anything she's done to undermine this mash.
I haven't done anything. Yes, I dated Wally. He was funny. He was a kind, gentle, decent boy. There was nothing subversive about it.
And it's really a simple matter. All you have to do is tell me who some of Mr. Crichton's other friends were.
What do you mean?
Simple. I want the names of people he associated with. Where they went, what they did.
That was a long time ago. There were so many friends. Some were Wally's, some were mine. I can't remember names.
What makes her personal life your business anyway, Williamson?
Colonel, if the Major really has nothing to hide, a few simple questions aren't going to do her any harm. Major, would you characterize yourself as a patriotic American?
Absolutely.
And you consider communism the principal threat to our way of life?
Yes, I do.
And if someone known to you supported the communist cause, would you not, as a patriotic American, want to bring that person to the attention of the authorities?
Yes, of course, but these
now,
people...
we needn't discuss this here. Take your time. Think about it.
What if she can't remember any names?
The Major is an intelligent, well-motivated woman. She'll remember.
Okay, let's say she can remember, Williamson. What if she just doesn't want to tell you?
Well, if she chooses not to cooperate, I would have no choice but to subpoena her to testify before the committee.
Testify before the committee?
You've read about the committee, Margaret. They make it very simple for you. You can either hang yourself or your friends.
Or both. Whatever you do, just showing up can cost you your career.
Please. Wait a minute. Let me think.
Don't tell this snake anything.
Bad advice. By her silence, she would be implicating herself in the Red Menace.
Don't tell us about the Red Menace. We're up to our ankles in it. It comes out of those kids you keep sending us.
I'm a reasonable man. I'll be here for 2 more days. That should give the Major ample opportunity to jog her memory. Which shouldn't be too difficult. For a model American.